So here's the video. So far we've learned about tinning our iron and tinning our wire, and now we're actually going to connect the wire to a board. These boards are really inexpensive. They're like $4 for $5 at Fry's. You can probably find them online even cheaper. And the reason that we're doing this is because you should really, really practice this and make sure you get it down. So you're just going to thread the wire through the board. We're going to do just like before when we tinned the wire and attach the soldering iron to one side, the solder to the other, and you just want drops of the solder to pool around on the board. Now, the trick to this is that you want to make sure that you get the right amount of solder on the little contact at the bottom that's called the copper pad. And kind of need to think of it like a Scantron test from being in school. You want to fill in the circle totally and completely. You don't want too little or too much filled in, or else it's not going to register. So just like a Scantron test, if you have too little, it's not going to make a connection. And if you have too much, it might leak over to another part that you don't want it to connect to, and your project's not going to work. Someone asked me online. They said that they were having problems getting the solder to melt, and what I'm going to let you guys know is you might be holding your soldering iron a little too high. Just move it down a little bit, and the closer you get to the solder, the hotter the wire will get, and it will melt way, way easier. So if you're having problems, give that a try. In another video, we're going to be attaching other components to a breadboard. So say, for example, you have something like an LED. This is going to be the exact same thing. You're going to put whatever it is you're connecting through your board. You're going to have your legs sticking out the other side, and you're going to attach the soldering iron to the wire, the LED to the wire. It's going to drip down. It's going to cover the little copper pad. It's going to be awesome, and it's going to go really quick, and you're going to be really excited because you did such a good job. Go you! The only thing that's really going to be different is that we are going to snip off the ends when we're done. Now, I'm going to show you on the video, most people are going to want to clip it down here really close to the bottom of the wire. And while that will work for a time, eventually you might have a problem with it. It might come loose, or the connection might not be so great. So I'm going to recommend leaving at least a little bit of the wire sticking out of the bottom of the solder, just because it'll be easier to fix later and it will make sure that it's got a better connection. And if you have to re-solder the connection, so much easier to do when you have that little extra wire. The other thing I'm going to mention is when you snip your wire, if you just hold the top of it when you go to snip it, that will keep it from flying off into space or toward your face. Not that that's ever happened to me, ever. Not fun. If this is your first time here and you want to catch up with the soldering videos, I'm going to put the playlist over here. I promise I have way more energy in those, and I'm actually wearing like lipstick and stuff. They're better. Let me know what you think of this video. Do you like the box in the background? Do you think I go slower when I'm tired? Give me feedback. Leave it in the comments below. Also, ask any questions. If you haven't yet and you would like to follow along with what we're doing, please subscribe. In the coming weeks, we are going to be doing a kit from Fry's that's less than $5 that you can follow along at home with and construct on your own. We're going to be doing soldering for art and crafts, and we're going to be making a sun catcher with a, Minecraft themed. I'm really tired, sorry. At the suggestion of my nephew Eric. Hey buddy! So I guess that is it for this video, and hopefully I'll be a little more organized next week, and I will see you guys then. Okay, bye!